Very sad story. A man incarcerated 44 years for a crime he never committed because of a corrupt police agency and a powerful family. Let's put up the picture before. There you go. And Mr. Simmons now. You're looking at Vincent Simmons, 70 years of age, of Louisiana. That's a picture on the right of his mugshot many years ago. Months after his release, Simmons vows for accountability and compensation for the years stolen from him. They framed him for a sex crime that he never did. They framed him. It was systematic, it was intentional, and it was coordinated. He was locked up for allegedly raping two white teenage girls in 1977. Now, back then, as long as you pointed to a black man, you were going to jail if you were the black man being pointed to. And that's what happened to Mr. Simmons. Let's put up the pictures. There you go. In the 70s, I want to remind you, Jim Crow dictated much of his life and led to several run-ins with the police as a juvenile. He had a juvenile record, which meant you were an easy target for cops to frame you for something. The crime he was framed for allegedly occurred May 9th, 1977. 14-year-old twin sisters Sharon and Karen Sanders with their then 18-year-old cousin, Keith Babordi. Sharon allegedly was raped by a black man they supposedly had given a ride to before he pulled a gun on them. But according to the lawsuit filed by Simmons, it was Labordi who allegedly raped his own cousin. There's more. After being picked up by the police, Simmons says police tried to coerce him into confessing for the rape and went as far as shooting him in the chest at the police station. You heard that right. But Simmons remained steadfast in proclaiming his innocence. Simmons, second from the left on this picture, in a lineup following his arrest on May 23rd, 1977. The twins were coached into accusing Simmons, and during the lineup, he was made to look guilty being the only man wearing handcuffs. The Labordi family was well connected in this parish and used their power to influence the police and frame Mr. Simmons. Look at the booking photo of Mr. Simmons, the young Mr. Simmons at that time, Louisiana State Penitentiary. On July 28, 1977, Simmons was sentenced to two consecutive 50-year terms by a jury of 11 white men and one black woman. Over the years, Simmons maintained his innocence, petitioning for his post-conviction, but denied more than a dozen times. In a revealing May 2022 interview on CBS News 48 Hours, Sharon to the left and Karen Sanders spoke about the incident, and Karen admitted to having had consensual sex with her cousin Keith prior to the alleged crime and on the night in question. While she still claims Simmons was guilty, over the years, the retellings of the incident between Keith and the twins became more and more inconsistent. Furthermore, a medical exam of the twins documented at the time there were no signs of sexual assault. This evidence was withheld from Simmons' lawyer. That is called a discovery violation. Here's Simmons with his current attorney, Justin Bonus. Okay. Bonus was convinced, this attorney was convinced Simmons had been wrongfully convicted, and in 2020 became the lawyer that made it his mission to to set him free. Attorney Bonas said the evidence led to Simmons' case getting a fresh look by the courts. According to the lawsuit, Keith Laborde admitted Simmons did not rape either of the sisters, and he had consensual sex with one of them and locked the other in the trunk on February 14th, 2022. Judge Bill Bennett sided with Simmons and vacated his conviction. After his release from prison, Simmons says he could only thank God. He wants the Laborde family and the parish officials or their heirs, and in some instances held accountable for the wrongful conviction. While Simmons' lawsuit does not list a specific dollar amount at this time, he says he wants to help to pay out in damages. He should get everything he wants. What happened here? White privilege, corruption, powerful family, cover up, law enforcement willing to do it. Boom. You have a victim, a real victim, a victim that spent 44 years of his life incarcerated, and he's not the only one. See, he represents a microcosm. There's a macrocosm of this dating back from the 60s, 70s and beyond, where literally the families did not actually bribe. Many of them were just powerful. And the law enforcement, the local agencies would bend to the will of white powerful people because they felt as if they were looking out for each other. So sometimes a bribe was not even required. This man's life was completely turned upside down because of lies. All right, Ben, thoughts on this?
Yeah, I mean, this is one of those things where like the most important thing for people to understand for this, I mean, for especially like for like white folks in the audience, right? That we need to understand, okay? Like put this in historical context. Star Wars, the first Star Wars movie came out that same year that he was put in prison, 1977. The first Star Wars movie. So think to yourself what the 1970s and 80s represented for you. And understand that at that same time, like the late 1970s is about when sundown towns were at their peak in the United States of America. We like to think about racism as though it's some ancient thing in American history. But the harsh reality is, right, is like this. Not only does this still happen to this day, but the like extreme degree that we think of when we think about like the history of racism in the United States of America, that was happening at the same time that people were running around pretending to be Luke Skywalker, right? And it's just very, very important to put these things together because you think about anybody that you know that talks about back in my day, we were watching Star Wars. And understand that their black families at the same age that had a very different experience of what the 1970s and 80s were.
And we're still trying to fight against the adverse policies, the racial inequity that permeates in our criminal justice systems today.